Hello friend, good morning to all of you. I am T.C. Bhoyer, assistant professor and head department of English, late Pushpadevi Patil Art Science College, Rissu. Today, through this slide, we are going to start a literary terms. And the first literary term is point of view. Actually, this literary term is prescribed for be a second year literature student in Sant Gadge Baba Amravati University, Amravati. So what is a point of view? Point of view is a technique used by a writer, most probably in a short story or a novel. It is a technique used by a writer to present characters, incidents and events. In a rough way, I am telling you. But actually, point of view is the perspective. What is this? This is a perspective through which people and incidents in a story are viewed by the reader. And it is closely tied to the narration of a story that I have told you, novel or a short story. In fiction, see now, in fiction, there are three points of view. There are three main points of view. So, the first one is first person point of view. The second is the second person point of view and the third person point of view. So, what is a point of view? I have explained you now. There is also definition given in this slide. In the first line, what is the definition of point of view? When we read a story, we means a reader, our attention is focused by the narrator's manner of presenting the story. Means what is point of view? Point of view is the narrator's manner of presenting the story. Point of view means narrator's manner of presenting the story. So this is a point of view. We can say in a different word, it is a perspective through which people, incidents, we can say characters and whatever is there in the story is viewed. So that is a point of view. Now we have to see what is a first person point of view. What is a first person point of view? We see or we saw point of view means narrator's manner of presenting the story or the perspective through which people are viewed. So the first person point of view means in the story we know there are characters. So the story is told from a first person's perspective. A story is presented from the first person's perspective. Story is presented from the manner of first person who tells the events. See, so that is known as a first person point of view. So the character who is a narrator in the first person point of view refers himself throughout the story as I, and this we can see through this example we can see through the following novels, means the opening lines of the following novels. What is the novel? Moby Dick. Who is the writer? Herman Melville. Herman Melville wrote Moby Dick, and that novel has a first person point of view, means a character of this novel is a narrator. What is the name of that character? It is given here, Ishmael. See, so the beginning of this novel, call me, me means I, call me Ishmael. This is the opening of this novel. So me is telling us or showing us the first person point of view. Call me Ishmael. Some years ago, never mind how long precisely, but he is telling, call me Ishmael. Some years ago, never mind how long precisely, having little or no money in my purse and nothing particular to interest me on shore, I thought I would sail about a little and see the watery part of the world. So this is the first person point of view. Narrator tells the story in this way. He refers himself, I, me, throughout the novel. One thing. Second thing, we come to know his perspective to look, what we can say, to look the events in that story. So this is the first person point of view. In the second slide, the same first person point of view is described, is presented, is illustrated more. See, when a character in the story is the narrator, first person point of view we have seen, Ishmael is the character, he is the main character. And here also, writer is telling, when the character in the story is the narrator, we can know only, apan kay mahit ghun shakto, what this person observes and hears about the other characters. We can know only what this person observes and hears about the other characters. The entire story is unfolded, ughad karne, unfolded to us from what this one character chooses to tell us. An example of this type of narrative is Emily Bronte's Wuthering Heights. See, in a first person point of view, when the character in that story is a narrator, then that character tells us the story of other character, or what we can say, the event. So we, means reader, don't have option to know more anything, because that character tells us, narrate us. An example of this type is Emily Bronte's Wuthering Heights. See, in this novel, where the entire story is narrated as seen from the point of view of the housekeeper, Nellie Dean. In Wuthering Heights, there was one character, Nellie Dean. Nellie Dean observed everything. He saw whatever happening in that novel, and she narrates whole story incident to us. She is able to narrate only those incidents that occurred while she was present, or which she knows about through others. Thus, we do not know anything about how Hindley is one character in that novel, Earnshaw, met his wife, or about his wedding, since Nellie knows nothing about it. We learn about Isabella Linton's troubled marriage with Heathcliff only through the letter she writes to Nellie. Did you get? Means there are so many things in that novel that we come to know through the letters that is written by one character to the another that Nelly Dean cannot present the whole story. Whatever she observes, whatever she knows, only those incidents and those things she presents, she narrates us. But remaining things, there are also other things, for example, Hindley Earnshaw's meeting with his wife and other, the trouble of Isabella Linton's and her marriage to Heathcliff. These things we, reader, as a reader, come to know from the letter. Whose letter? Isabella's letter. So this is a first person point of view presented or used this term in a short story or a novel. See, now the second person point of view. In a second person point of view narrative, narrator always address himself throughout the story as a second person pronoun. For example, you. The opening, so there is one example given by, means written a novel by Jan McInerney's, J. McInerney's novel. The title of this novel is Bright Light Big City. And the lines are given here of this novel. See, most famous quote of this novel. You are not the kind of a guy who would be at a place like this at this time of the morning. See, you means narrator. You are not the kind of a guy, guy means a boy, who would be at a place like this at this time of the morning. But here you are, and you cannot say the terrain is entirely unfamiliar, although the details are fuzzy. So you in this novel is presented, and it represented as a second person point of view. And what is the title of this novel? Bright Lights Big City. Mothya shaharat khup mothe light astat. So J. McInerney's novel. Just remember these examples, they might ask you in a objective question. So just remember. See, what is the feature of second person point of view novel? See, the second person point of view is extremely rare. This is a rare technique. No one uses it. It is a difficult technique. So not very few writer used this second person point of view in a story, their story. Rare when compared to the first person and the third person. See, this narrative point of view is used for what? This mode is more common to song lyrics. Kashala vaparli jate? He second person point of view song lyrics sati. Or to non-fiction manuals. Kashala sati? Non-fictional manuals. Non-fictional manuals ka hai ta? Such as self-help books, cookbooks or guide books. याचा साथी ही second person point of view वापरली जाते. So just remember it. I am telling you, they might ask you in a exam as an objective question. So first person, second person. Example of first person, Moby Dick and Wuthering Heights. Example of second person, Bright Lights Big City by J. McInerney. See, the next example of second person point of view. The French author Michael Butler wrote a Second Thoughts. The name of the novel, Second Thoughts. And this is also the example of second person point of view. Another example of a novel written from the second person point of view. Other novelists have attempted, dusryahi novelist ne he vaparla parantu full nahi tar kai limited parmanat, have attempted the mode in limited sections of their novels. For example, Italo Calvino's If on a Winter's Night a Traveler. Italo Calvino's postmodern narrative hai If on a Winter's Night a Traveler. आणि स्कॉटिश राइटर ने एक लिहिलेली यान बँक्स ने, काय नॉवेलचं नाव, अ सॉन्ग ऑफ स्टोन. आता ह्या आहेत आता दोन सेकंड पर्सन पॉइंट ऑफ व्ह्यू मध्ये लिहिलेल्या बट नॉट इन अ फुल वे बट इन अ लिमिटेड वे. कुठल्या कुठल्या काही भागामध्ये सेकंड पर्सन पॉइंट ऑफ व्ह्यू वापरलेला आहे. परंतु सेकंड थॉट्स कोणाची? मायकल बटरची. आणि त्याच्या अगोदर आपण पाहिलेली कुठली होती? ती होती ब्राईट लाईट्स बिग सिटी, जे मॅकिनर्नेची आर द बेस्ट एक्झाम्पल ऑफ सेकंड पर्सन पॉइंट ऑफ व्ह्यू. डिड यू गॉट द सेकंड पर्सन पॉइंट ऑफ व्ह्यू? द थर्ड पॉइंट इज थर्ड पर्सन पॉइंट ऑफ व्ह्यू. अँड इन अ थर्ड पर्सन पॉइंट ऑफ व्ह्यू नरेटर इज ऑलवेज रेफर्ड टू थर्ड पर्सन प्रोनाउन. फॉर एक्झाम्पल सी, ही, दे और बाय नेम किंवा मोस्ट प्रॉबेबली नाव सुद्धा घेतली जातात. इन अदर वर्ड्स द एक्झाम्पल ऑफ इन अदर वर्ड्स द नरेटर इज नॉट अ कॅरेक्टर. कॅरेक्टर असतो का त्याच्यातलं? जसं फर्स्ट पर्सन मध्ये नेली डीन आणि इस्माईल आपण बघितले कॅरेक्टर. परंतु याच्यातलं कॅरेक्टर मात्र हे व्यक्ती नसतो, नरेटर हा कॅरेक्टर नसतो. कशात? थर्ड पर्सन पॉइंट ऑफ व्ह्यू मध्ये. इन अदर वर्ड्स द नरेटर इज नॉट अ कॅरेक्टर. टेक अ लुक ऍट दिस एक्स्ट्रॅक्ट फ्रॉम जॉर्ज ऑरवेल्स 1984. जॉर्ज ऑरवेल नावाच्या लेखकाने 1984 नावाची नॉव्हेल लिहिलेली आहे आणि त्याच्यात हे थर्ड पर्सन पॉइंट ऑफ व्ह्यू बेस्ट दिलेलं आहे. बघा व्हॉट इज द बिगिनिंग, सॉरी व्हॉट इज द हाऊ दॅट नॉव्हेल यूज अ थर्ड पर्सन पॉइंट ऑफ व्ह्यू. सी, इट वॉज अ ब्राईट कोल्ड डे इन एप्रिल. दिस इज द ओपनिंग लाईन ऑफ धिस नॉव्हेल. इट वॉज अ ब्राईट कोल्ड डे इन एप्रिल अँड द कुक सॉरी अँड द क्लॉक्स वेअर स्ट्रायकिंग 13. विन्स्टन स्मिथ हिज चिन नझल्ड इन टू हिज ब्रेस्ट इन अन एफर्ट टू एस्केप द व्हील वाइंड स्लिप क्विकली थ्रू द ग्लास डोअर्स ऑफ व्हिक्ट्री मॅन्शन्स दो नॉट क्विकली इनफ टू प्रिव्हेंट अ स्विर्ल ऑफ ग्रिटी डस्ट फ्रॉम एंटरिंग अलॉंग विथ हिम. सो विन्स्टन स्मिथ म्हणजे डायरेक्ट नाव दिलेलं आहे. ही, सी किंवा दे न वापरता डायरेक्ट नाव घेतलेलं आहे कोणाचं? नरेटरचं. तर काय नाव? विन्स्टन स्मिथ इज द नरेटर ऑफ दिस नॉव्हेल. नॉव्हेलचं नाव 1984. कोण लिहिली? जॉर्ज ऑरवेलनं. सो धिस इज द एक्झाम्पल ऑफ थर्ड पर्सन पॉइंट ऑफ व्ह्यू. सी, अदर एक्झाम्पल्स आर ऑल्सो देअर. द नॉव्हेल्स ऑफ जेन ऑस्टिन आर गुड एक्झाम्पल ऑफ थर्ड पर्सन नरेटिव्ह. बघा जेन ऑस्टिनच्या 6 नॉव्हेल आहेत. मग त्याच्यात अनेक आहेत. फॉर एक्झाम्पल यम्मा, प्राईड अँड प्रिज्युडाईज, नॉर्थेंगर अबे अँड सो मेनी. सो ऑल दीज नॉव्हेल्स आर इन अ थर्ड पर्सन पॉइंट ऑफ व्ह्यू. सो द नॉव्हेल्स ऑफ जेन ऑस्टिन आर इन अ थर्ड पर्सन पॉइंट ऑफ व्ह्यू. द थर्ड पर्सन नरेटिव्ह मोड कुड बी स्टडीड अंडर टू हेडिंग्स. म्हणजे या थर्ड पर्सन मध्ये थर्ड पर्सन पॉइंट ऑफ व्ह्यू मध्ये दोन प्रकार आहेत किंवा दोन पॉइंट आहेत. पहिला आहे ओमनिसियंट आणि दुसरा आहे लिमिटेड. बघा आपल्याला बघायचं अन ऑथर हु अडॉप्ट द रोल ऑफ अ थर्ड पर्सन ओमनिसियंट नरेटर अज्युम्स अ वॅन्टेज पॉइंट अँड इज नॉट ओनली एबल टू recount the action thoroughly and reliably but is also able to enter the mind of any character in the work in order to reveal his or her thoughts, feelings and beliefs directly to the reader. The novels of Leo Tolstoy such as War and Peace are good examples of this type. Which type? War and Peace. Omniscient third person narrative point of view. War and Peace, Leo Tolstoy. Omniscient third person point of view. Now we have to see the next part. Third person point of view but limited third person point of view. See, what is the difference between limited third person point of view and omniscient third person point of view? In omniscient third person point of view, narrator is free to present the inner thoughts and feelings of the character. And in a limited third person point of view, the narrator recounts the story through the eyes of a single character or a few of his characters and presents the story as seen from their point of view. In this mode of storytelling, we usually learn a great deal about the private history and the thoughts of one character in the story. See, usually we learn a great deal about the private history and the thoughts of one character in the story. Henry James called such a character the focus or the center of consciousness. Means in a limited. In James' novel, What Macy Knew, the story is recounted solely from the point of view of a child, the limited point of view, gradually developed into the sophisticated stream of consciousness technique in the 20th century. So these are the basic difference between limited point of view and omniscient point of view. In omniscient point of view, that author is free to present the feelings and emotions of any character, and in a limited point of view, the writer is not fully free, he has some limitation, and that Henry James called such kind of writing is a center of consciousness. Did you got the meaning? So these are the types of narrative. These are the types of narrative.